Hello everyone, my name is Brian and welcome to another Smite commentary, and for today we will be playing Chiron in Arena, and this is exactly the setup I want to be against if I'm playing Chiron. You might wonder, why do you want to play against a Kumba Kana, a Nox, a Tyr, a Kali? Well, Kali and Tyr, not too important, but most important in my opinion is for the Kumba and Nox, because I like playing against them when I play Chiron. Only when I play Chiron, and that's for one reason and one reason only. I'm mentioning to my team the fact that I can cleanse. I can use my one to cleanse Kumba mess, I can cleanse the Kumba root, I can cleanse the Nox root, and that way deny an insane amount of damage on the, on my teammates, save lives and such. That's also why I level up my 2 first. If you've seen any of my other videos where I play Chiron in Arena against a lot of CCs, I will level up my 2 first because I don't really want to rely on the damage of my 1. And with that, I won't be using my 1 that much, so I can just cleanse. And as you can see, I cleansed a little bit late, still a bit rusty, haven't done it too long. Haven't done it in a long time, I mean. So, yeah. Let's see, can we get Fearless Blood already? It looks like he went for a very aggressive Fearless. I did use my Purification Beads, so I do need to be a little bit careful against the Kumba Kana. But other than that, I should be fine. Of course I do need to make sure that I don't get comboed by the Nox. If that happens, then I will have a lot of damage. A lot of damage on me. Too much damage, to be fair. I'm not completely sure yet what I want to build. There are a couple of builds. At one game before this one, went pretty well, to be honest, as well. But the enemies didn't have as many CCs, so I couldn't really utilize the fact that my one cleanses that much. I think I'll go for a Transcendence build, because I want to have more mana to spend my abilities. And if I get more attack speed with the Transcendence, my attacks will also deal just a bit more damage. There are a couple of builds you can go for. There's one build I liked a lot before a couple of changes, before, for instance, Wind Demon came out. That was the build with Ikaval and Chintz afterwards, followed up by Asi. With that, you have the core 5, core 4, I mean, Boots into Ikaval into Chintz into Asi. And after that, you can kind of follow it up with Hastened or some penetration if you need it. There are a lot of options. For this one, I'm going for a Transcendence build. I want to try out how well it works with him. I think it works pretty well because his abilities deal a decent amount of damage as well. And it will help out if I am in a sticky situation where I need to use my ultimate to try and get a kill to revive myself. I don't see a high opportunity for that. The chance of you getting a kill with your ultimate are quite low when it comes to a team fight, because you need to have someone at low HP already, and then you need to finish him off without you being able to chase him down. So yeah, it makes it for a difficult situation if you are ever in that situation. You're better off using that ultimate for the CC immunity rather than using it for the enable to the unable to die portion, because you won't be... Oh crap, talking about unable to die, I am dead. Yeah, my purification boots were down. I was a little bit late on the reaction. Tia blinked in. He wasn't fearlessing me immediately, so I should have just popped my ultimate for the CC immunity rather than just dying, because with that push from the tier straight into the Nox combo, nothing I could have done. My purification beads were down for like 5 seconds. You guessed it. It's always the situation that if you're pulled or plucked or whatever, you're like, no, I have my purification beads in like 5 seconds. I'm so fucked. You're like, oh, why didn't he attack me 5 seconds later? Then you would have been fine. I mean, then I would have just beat the Fearless from Tyr and I would be fine. But no. At least I have it up for now. He misses this completely. Still didn't really want to use my ultimate. Yield ultimate is also not only CC immune tool, it's also a potential kill tool with the amount of damage you can do from it from an insane amount of range. Bit of too much range. And not as much damage as I expected, but that's fine. I saved a point at level 8 to make sure that I have an additional point in my ultimate and my 2. Because I will be using my 1 a lot to cleanse. Although the cooldown on it is a little bit too long for me to save the Aquarian and, well, the gap. Although you can't really cleanse the tier juggle, you can't cleanse that one. So that's something you want to consider. Ooh, nice ultimate by the Kali. I hope she doesn't get a target. I think it's Anubis at least. Doesn't look like she wants to commit. And I can't really fight him, the Rama, because he has the Ikaval. So that gives him a huge advantage, as you can see, Ikaval. And it gives him a huge advantage if we're fighting each other. He doesn't only have penetration and more attack speed than I do, but he also can steal, or kind of, the Ikaval works in a way that if you're fighting against an Ikaval and you don't have it, they will deal a lot more damage to you than you will be dealing to them. And that makes for a lot of difficult situations if you're not kind of prepared to instantly burst him down before he's able to confirm his basics. Because if you hit your basics at the same time, at the same moment, then he will definitely has the edge. Because he kind of reduces the damage ideal to him. So I will be going for that one. I actually wanted to go for an Aasi. I like Aasi with the Transcendence a lot more. That's one of my favorite builds. If I go for that Aasi, then I'll go Boots into Transcendence into Aasi. With that, I have Lifesteal, I have Penetration, I have Attack Speed, I have a lot of power, I have a lot of additional mana. Just overall a very good build. With Ikaval, I don't have any Lifesteal, so that's the only downside to it. It does provide me more. Can I hit him? You can't juke it out! Nice! Knocked up by the Kuma. He is the only one attacking me, so he should be fine. He actually rooted me while I was dashing, so that will stop my dash. That's something you have to consider if you are playing Chiron. Roots will just stop your dash. The dash animation and the fact that you'll push back someone will just continue, as well as you will just continue running once the root wears off. But if that's not the case, then you'll be rooted and you will be kind of walking in place. It's almost like a reverse moonwalk. You're trying to move forward, but you're not moving an inch. Yeah. The stacks aren't too important. I'm usually not really going to complain about not getting stacks. I think my teammates have stacks as well. But stacks are, in my opinion, with the Transcendence, not the most important part. Of course, it provides you a little bit of power, a little bit of mana. So it's not bad to get the stacks. But I feel like it's not something that has a huge priority. For instance, if you have someone in your team that has a Warlock Sash, always has priority. Devour's Gauntlet always has priority. Doomop always has priority. Unless, of course, he dies a million times, then at some point you must say, no, I'm not going to give you any stacks, you will die for them with them anyway. But if that's the case, you probably shouldn't have built Doomop to begin with. Now, that's also something. I saw in Habois, I was playing Conquest a bit today, and I saw in Habois building Doomop, but he was first blooded. Then you should not ever build a Doomop if you get first blooded, because you will be only behind and behind if you're not able to survive. Especially as a Habois, very difficult for you to survive. If you don't have your ultimate, you can't really get out of any sticky situation. Can I hit him? No, I can't hit him. I am absolutely terrible at aiming, apparently. If I hit him once, I could have used my 2 to finish him off with my masterful shot or skill shot or whatever. Yeah, a bit unfortunate. Let's just get sprint. I'm not too worried about their finishing abilities. There are two of them. They have the Rama ultimate and the Nox ultimate. They are decent finishing moves, but I feel like it's not really something I want to worry about too much. And with the sprint, I can kind of get away from the Kali if it's necessary, as well as provide my team some additional movement speed to either engage or disengage. It's an option. If you're against high burst teams, it's usually better to go for Sanctuary. Think of Habois, Vulcan, mages like that, Scylla, then Sanctuary is a very good option. But in this combo in particular, I feel like it is not really going to help an awful lot. Because if I get comboed by Nox, there's nothing I can do against it, even if I have Sanctuary, if I don't have Purification beats up. Same for the Kali, that's actually, Sanctuary for Kali is also not bad, to be completely honest. They're pushing me into my base. I'm completely fine with that. I'll gladly retreat to the base. If he pushed me towards my team, then I would have been in an awkward spot. But that's not really the case. ultimate use body Kali. Can't really do anything about that. I'll just make sure that these minions don't get through. Which is probably same. Ooh, can he get out? Ooh, nice. He's able to get out. Okay, I didn't expect him to get out, to be honest. I mean, 3-1. Nice purification beats, but still. 3-1. Difficult to get out, usually. Well done. It is. As you can see, that's exactly what I meant. I was rooted by the Kuma, and my knockback portion was still active. So when he walked next to me, I pushed him back. Even though I was standing at the same spot. Ooh, Kali, a lot of damage. I need to get out. I'm fine. Doesn't look like the Susano is out that easily. Yeah, too many. He uses purification beads the last time to get away from three, so he didn't have those up. Something important to note always, you always want to make sure that you know which gods have used their abilities. Looks like Anubis is going to get engaged on. No room for us to go for that, and yeah, I'm not going to kind of commit on that one. I could have walked the other way. It's a bit of a risk because the tier can just juggle me into this wall here, as well as I'm way too close to Akali, and I don't want to be close to Akali. I wanted to cleanse the stun for the Anubis, and that's literally all I could have done from that moment. We were a bit too outnumbered. Don't want to risk it. If I commit too much on trying to save the Anubis, I'll die as well, and that's definitely never worth it. Unless you can save him, then you actually trade your life for his. Sometimes worth it, not always, depends on what you are as well. If you're a support, then it's always worth it to give your life up for someone that can deal a lot of damage. But you kind of ultimate use by the... Oh, nice combo as well. He actually blocked my 3. I tried to dash it away immediately. Got caught by the tier, fearless. But with a gap shield, I should be completely fine. Nothing to worry about. A little bit more gold and I will be able to get my chins online. That's the next thing I'll go for. I kind of want to get through those high HP targets. Looks like there's a lot of damage on the... Can I kill him? I can't confirm the last hit. Let's just use my 2. Maybe it's enough. It will follow the Kali. Doesn't look like it's enough. I could have tried to fire another shot to make sure that I hit it. If I hit it, maybe my 2 would have been enough. I honestly don't think so. And even if it was, I probably would have died as well. Because I'm in my ultimate, I have a lot slower movement speed, and it makes for difficult escape. The enemies were quite close, so I chose to just cancel my ultimate after the 2 shots are fired and run away immediately to make sure that I at least survive. You have the chins online for now. I will be trying to poke out anyone that's in front of me. Kuma as well. I mean, Kuma is not squishy at all, but if he's the only one around, why not attack him? I mean, you have absolutely no reason not to attack him. You don't want to commit too many abilities on him, of course, because he is quite tanky. But especially, as you can see, nice cleanse. I love how you can deny entire Nox in her entirety. The only thing Nox can get guaranteed if I'm around is her ultimate. Because she can't get the combo off if I have my 1 up. And then she has literally no damage because no one is going to stay inside that silence. So that's something I like about Chiron a lot, and I feel like it's sometimes a little bit underutilized. But it's just, I don't know, I just like it that much. There was a time where I didn't use it either, but then I kind of practiced it for a bit. I've told this in other videos as well, but that's something I wanted to mention again. I just deliberately came into a game with Chiron in the hope that on the enemy side was a heavy CC comp. And with that, I would just level up my 2. I will keep my 1. Never use it offensive. Especially if you have it rank 1, it will deal no damage offensive. So that's completely fine. Let's see. I was waiting for the mess, but he didn't go for the mess. Oh, he went. That's unfortunate. I used purification beads to try and avoid the tier push. But he didn't go for me. What I was mentioning. I wanted to go for that save on the Anubis. Or just a... Oh, I'm so dead. The cleanse on the Anubis, because he was rooted, I figured that Kuma would follow up with a mess on the Anubis, because he's an immobile target, quite squishy as well. He went for us. That's the only downside of me being the cleanser. If I'm CC'd, I can't cleanse. But back to the point, let's see, can we deal the damage? Nope. But like I was mentioning, I just went to do a game, kind of wished for a heavy CC comp on the opponent's side, picked up purification beads for myself, and kept my my one at rank one. Well, once I've reached the maximum level in my two and my ultimate, then I was leveling my one, because you can use it as a damage ability, but I mainly wanted to use it as a CC cleanser because it's so potent. And by practicing that a couple of games, I actually am able to pretty consistently use it to save teammates, and that's something that I feel is just awesome. I really think that's awesome. Luckily enough, I was not oh, I need to defend this. Gap, you got this? Probably not. I do want to make sure that these minions don't get through. If I let those minions get through and survived, then that would be a 8-point swing for them. But if I died in a process, even if I died in a process and I stopped every single minion, then it's still in our advantage. Because if I let those minions get through, then we'll lose more points. You might think, you'll lose only 1 point. Oh, wow, that Kali is shredding me. Holy crap. Okay, back to the point. If I let those minions through, you will lose 4 points. But if you don't kill the minions, the enemies won't lose those 4 points either. So it's an 8-point swing if you let 4 minions go through. So it's always better to stop an entire minion wave and die than let an entire minion wave go through, because you'll lose a lot more points with that. Just a little tip if you're playing. Of course, there are situations where you just don't want to die and later recognize that there are minions going through, then yeah, if you're not able to get there in time or safely enough, like it's guaranteed that you'll die and it's not guaranteed that you'll get the wave, then it's not worth it, of course. Come on. Dear, pick a side, damn it. Never mind, I'll try and help out his son. I gave him the movement speed with my sprint. He might be able to get out. He's kind of baiting them to the other side, using his one to escape. Looks like the ultimate from the Rama is in the air, but that won't be enough, and we're able to pick up that Rama. Sweet. He's in there. Oh, I hate Mantle of Discord. That's one of the big downsides if you, as a hunter, go close to a target. I was just barely too close, and because of that, the Mantle of Discord procced when he went below 30% HP. With that, procking that AoE stun was just barely in range of that. That sucks. Let's get rid of that potion. Let's get the Witchblade. If you're wondering why I'm getting Witchblade, it's definitely not something I would ever pick up. They did buff it last patch, and it makes it for a very, very powerful tool to begin with. Especially for warriors and tanks, of course. But in this situation, the only one I'm really dying to is the enemy Kali. And on the enemy side is also a Rom. So that means that they have a lot of attack speed on their side. And with that, and physical damage, because they also have the tier for the physical damage. Ooh. Well, that's definitely worth it in my opinion. Getting rid of that Kali ultimate will make sure that we'll be able to, if we CC her, kill her. And she won't be able to get that ultimate off. But they have three physicals. So the physical protection on the Witchblade will be very useful. I think it's 60 protections. So it's definitely very good. It provides me attack speed, which is never bad, and also, most importantly, reducing the enemy attack speed by, I think, 20% or something like that, and reducing their power as well. So that will be very useful against the enemy Kali. Let's see, can we do something? Looks like he's not going to commit on the Anubis, just in case he would be. I could have cleansed, for instance, a mess or a root. Don't have it up anymore, I use it for damage. Please don't die, Anubis, I'm sorry, I should have kept my cleanse. Prematurely using my beads, not want to be stunned by that Kali. Also, a couple of things you can cleanse which can be useful is, for instance, curse, weakening curse. You can cleanse it on yourself, on others as well. Most CCs you can't really cleanse on yourself because you're CC'd. Roots can be cleansed, so that's something you can also do. If, for instance, I get rooted by the Nox without the silence, I can just use my one on top of myself and cleanse that. Make sure that I get that safely. And as you can see, as I mentioned, I got rid of the curse with that cleanse on myself as well as on the Gap. Sweet. Nice cripple from the Rom. Will do a lot of damage to me with his basics, but I'm not going to fight him. Looks like Anubis already done that. And that will secure that kill. He's decent amount of damage. And Kali ultimate being down will secure that kill as well. Sweet, we're still quite ahead. 30 points at this stage is a lot. It's still only like, it's 6 kills. Kind of depends on how the mini waves go as well. If for instance they stall out the game now, we will lose, well, I think 7 points per wave. And they will only lose 1, so that's kind of a way for them to stall it. Decent damage, Kali ultimate forced out. I think she will be able to get out. Yes, it looks like she can. She did have her leap up, so she will be able to get into the base safely with her ultimate pop as well. Also, good counter for Kali if you're lucky enough to be, well, when you're playing casual. And Saket against the Kali. If Kali uses her ultimate and you use your ultimate after that as a Kali, you will kill her. Because she can't heal. So that's definitely a very, very powerful tool. Can we get that tier? There's only 1 kill left to go. Maybe we can go for the Kali. Doesn't look like it. Still only 1 kill to go. Oh, never mind. We won. In my corner of my eye, I saw minions walking through the portal. There was no one near them to stop the minions. So that will secure the victory for us. 5-3-12. Not a huge part of the kills, but definitely a good part. And still, even though I wasn't able to cleanse an awful lot, still a couple of cleanses where it felt like, nice. Able to get rid of an entire combination from the Nox. Which is quite difficult to deal with sometimes. Especially if you have a Nox that's very consistent with it. And will always go for that kind of combination on enemies. And not so much on the wave. Then you will have a rough time dealing with that. But like I said, I can just cleanse it immediately with my 1. If I wait too long though, they will still be hit by the 2. So I do need to make sure that I react as quick as possible to make sure that I cleanse it immediately. So they will be able to walk out safely. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed this Chiron Arena. Definitely a lot of fun. And I like this skin actually, this awesome skin. The Moose. I think that's a really awesome skin. Kind of Canadian theme Moose skin. It's a lot of fun. Although I do need to say that his Hellrider skin is awesome as well. Can't really pick between those two. I haven't really played as the Moose. So I figured, why not pick the Moose? The Moose is awesome. Hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you guys so much for watching. Thanks for all the support. Really appreciate it. All the comments. Really love it. If you have any requests, please let me know. Game mode, gods, builds, etc. As always. Hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you guys. And as always, good luck. Have fun. I'll see you guys in the next one.